Oh, it's Saskatchewan MP Andrew Scheer who's officially jumping into the race today. That makes like a dozen people running or considering a run. So how will Scheer try to stand out from the competition? Joining me now, Saskatchewan MP and now Conservative leadership hopeful, Andrew Scheer. Nice to see you.
Good to see you again. That's okay. The Conservative way is to be ardent defenders and promoters of the things that make Canada great and encourage new Canadians to adopt those values.
So would you promote and defend the equality of marriage?
It's the law of the land, and it's that's not something that I don't think you'd find any legitimate Conservative leadership aspirant who would revisit that issue.
But do you yourself believe it?
I do. It's look, it's absolutely our party dealt with this issue in Vancouver, and there was a specific policy plank in our platform, and I think members decided, a lot of social conservatives who have differing views on that decide, look, if it's not something that's ever going to be changed, it's been this way for 10 years. I have my own personal beliefs and my own faith background, but at this point in time, with the Conservative Party of Canada trying to build a national viable coalition, it's not something that's
that sounds like you're gonna live with it. You're gonna live with the fact that gay people can get married. It's not something you believe in.
Look, it doesn't matter. Like, people have personal views on things. There's a lot of things that divide us as conservatives. There's a lot of things that unite us. I think this is one of those issues that it happened in 2005. I was a member of parliament at the time. I voted my conscience. I voted my constituents' wishes. It's not something that you say live with it. It's not something that I'm looking to revisit or to reopen or things like that. I think the party has other things that we want to talk about and connect with Canadians and deliver for their futures.
What about abortion? Are you for abortion, a woman's right to choose, or not?
Again, you point to my record in the House of Commons.
Yeah, I mean, I have to ask you the questions because of the record in the past and to see where you are now and what you're going to offer.
It's totally fine. Yeah. But a big theme of my leadership campaign is, you take all the things that we agree on, put it on one whiteboard. Take all the things that we disagree on as conservatives, put it on another whiteboard. Yep. Which whiteboard should we focus on? Which item should we go to tick off? Our party and our caucus have constantly said that we don't want this issue to be reopened. We don't want to have this as an election issue. We don't want to have our caucus divided over this issue. So I think it's one of the things that held our coalition together, was that some of these divisive issues were not brought forward as the government. So as Prime Minister, I would maintain that commitment to my caucus and the party that these issues wouldn't be reopened. There's so much that we agree on that we can achieve and we can win on.
But again, do you believe in that right? Because Brad Trost, who shares some of these values with you, is very openly defending the fact that he doesn't like gay marriage and that he doesn't like abortion. So do you believe that women should have that right or not?
Look, as I said, my personal views on this have always been consistent. I'm an authentic person. I am pro-life. I've always expressed that, and I've absolutely been consistent on that. But does that mean that the leader of the Conservative Party or the Prime Minister of Canada should initiate legislation on that to open up that issue when our own caucus is not united on that? And that's where I think that there may be a separation between myself and other candidates on this. So I'm going, my whole campaign theme and going to the next election is, what are the things that we can all agree on that we can achieve electoral success and that we can achieve on as government? Some of these issues you're talking about very likely wouldn't survive constitutional challenges. So what's the value in talking about them now? What's the value of having internal divisions and then going out divided in front of Canadians in the next election?